seats being elected on the basis of the general seats secured by or won by each political party.
In 2002 is the 10th Amendment.
This is the 2002 Assembly is the 12th National Assembly, and it's the 17th Amendment which validated what had happened prior to the 2002 Assembly and brought in Article 51 in its present form. Paragraph 6 went through one amendment, the 18th Amendment, where previously a political party securing less than 5% seats in the National Assembly was disentitled by way of a proviso. So that proviso was done away with via 18th Amendment. My Lord, the number is 60, and this is a clear, there is a clear intent behind it, which indicates that after the 18th Amendment, 17th Amendment, a larger representation was sought. And what was commanded has been commanded by the Parliament. So my respectful submission is that whether you look at the purpose or the text of this clause, the purpose is only one, which is ensuring representation of women in large numbers, in this number, in the Parliament, and the non-Muslims being given this role, greater role in national electoral politics by way of giving them right to vote for general seats, and then their members, the non-Muslims getting elected indirectly on the basis of general seats secured by political parties whom non-Muslims all over the country for various different national assembly seats vote for. The tool being the political party, the vehicle, the engine being the political party. And thirdly, the system. And now here I will take you through the electoral systems in place and then bring you to the system which we call now the proportional representation system of political parties list. I believe CMA 5911 is before your lordships and your ladyship. This is the written synopsis of my submissions. 5911. If
you would be reading from it,
by page 8, if you may kindly turn to page 8. I'll just quickly walk you through various systems in place, but Roman numeral 1, 2, and 3 and 3's B and C are relevant for the purposes of this, and these are the systems which are relevant for our purpose, and hence I have tried to briefly, succinctly try to explain them. The first being the first past the post method, which is also called single non-transferable vote. This is the method which is used to elect members on the general seats. Basically, the plurality system, whoever gets more votes, regardless of whether they have exceeded 50% or not, gets elected. The second being the single transferable vote, which is also called proportional rank choice voting. Now, this is something, this is a method which is used to elect the Senate in Pakistan under Clause 2 of Article 59. And single transferable vote basically means that a candidate or a voter votes for multiple candidates. And if in the process, amongst his options, whoever either gets elected by securing more votes or gets eliminated by securing less votes, his vote gets transferred to the next and is ultimately applied to one or either candidates, whoever he votes for. But this is for the Senate. Now the third, which is relevant for the purposes of this discussion, this is proportional representation system, political parties list, I'll call it PRPL. Now, under this system, there are two ways to elect members under PRPL. One is by way of popular vote, which we don't apply here, but in some of the other jurisdictions, this system is applied. And in simpler terms, the way this system on the basis of popular vote works is that the political parties present their candidates, offer their candidates by way of a list. So it is also always based on party list basis. And based on the popular vote, the percentage of popular vote secured by a political party, the percentage of votes secured would apply to the list, and let's say if a party has secured 51%, then 51% of the members on that list will get elected. So this is PRPL on the basis of popular vote. At page 8, towards the bottom, under Roman numeral 3, This is this is in inverted commas. This is an excerpt from Reeve and Ware, aggregating votes, rival systems in electoral systems, a comparative and theoretical introduction. I'll just quickly read out. Page 8 at the bottom. This is a class of system whose special feature is the role of parties in presenting list of candidates to the voters. The effect of these parties list is to rank the candidates, the party's order of preference among the candidates so that an individual voter, in casting a vote for that party, will simply be allocating his or her vote to whoever is next on the party list. The core theme being that the election on PRPL basis is reserved only for the political parties. It is the political party, as I have explained, being the tool or the engine which to whom or which is entitled to receive those votes and which is entitled to then get elected the candidates which are on its list, and based on the seats which are secured or whatever proportion is worked out, they get the seats are allocated to them. Now, page 9, this is the paragraph B is what is relevant for our purposes, B and also C, because there is an interface between the two of them. Now, this is PRPL based on general seats, which is the system method we are following here. And what this then entails is that ours is a system which is called mixed member proportional representation, which is outlined in paragraph C, where some seats are elected or filled through general elections, first past the post method, and then the reserved seats to be elected on the basis of PRPL are pegged with those general seats, and those the number of general seats will then find how many seats each party is entitled to. But the foundational theme being twofold. First, the seats must always be filled, because the purpose of the constitution or the text is giving representation to women and the non-Muslims. So the constitution, by very nature of its purpose and text also, does not envisage that any of these seats reserved for women and non-Muslims is left vacant. That would defeat the purpose of the constitution and the intent of the legislature also. And two, it's the general seats will define. But what then happens is that while filling these seats, the question obviously is, and asked also, what will happen if there are independents who get elected, and what will the effect of those independents be on filling these seats, or on working out, or effect of the independents on the proportion is for the purposes of filling these seats.
So you said two principles. One was seats must always be filled. What's the second one?
The second is, my lord, that while filling these seats, and it's as a corollary to it, is that while ensuring that the seats are filled, the independents have to be excluded for the purposes of working out the formula based on which the proportionate representation is afforded to political parties.
Where do you get this from?
Ji, main bhi ab aa raha hu uski taraf.
Is this formula fixed or it is changing from time to time?
No, it does not change, and I'll show you why and how. Now, if you may kindly turn to page 11. This is a formula which I... So this is a formula in a simpler form which I have placed before your lordships and your ladyship. I'll also show you how the National Assembly, the 12th National Assembly, I'll call it 12th National Assembly, which is the 2002 Parliament, where for the first time the large number of these seats were sought to be filled through proportional representation of party list, how that National Assembly filled those seats.
No,
and the successive national and provincial
assembly. This formula is not in conformity with the rule 94 provided in the election rules.
My lord, I'll attend to
the
that.
The constitution says this has to be filled in accordance with law, and the only law is election rules.
I'll attend
and
to
the
that.
Rule 94 does not say so.
I'll attend to that, sir. Okay. I'll attend to that. This is something which, during the course of my submissions, I'll attend to this question. Now, if you kindly take a look at paragraph number 14. Now, this formula is basically for the purposes of calculation and working out how many general seats would be required to fill in one reserve seat. And here, my lords would see that A is the total number of general seats in the relevant house, B is the total number of independents. And C is the total number of reserve seats. And in order to explain it, if I may take you to page 13. So I've taken Balochistan Assembly as the benchmark, having lesser number of seats and relatively not much of mathematics involved, or simpler in those terms. So to fill in 16 seats, so Balochistan Assembly has 16 National Assembly seats, general seats, and 4 reserve seats for women, which makes the number total 20. Now, according to this formula...
Yeah, just a minute. ये जो 4 seats है, ये 16 seat की बुनियाद पे मिले. Allocation of 4 seats to province. This is on the basis of these 16 seats.
मैं यही आपको भी एक्सप्लेन करूंगा, एक्चुअल एग्जांपल भी दिखाऊंगा कि आज की बलूचिस्तान से जो रिप्रेजेंटेशन है वो क्या है, और अगर ये जो 2 सिनेरियोस मैंने आपके सामने रखे हैं इसके नीचे, उससे जरा क्लियर होता जाएगा ये सवाल भी. सो लेट्स अस्यूम दैट आउट ऑफ दी 16 सीट्स देयर इज नो इंडिपेंडेंट, थिंग्स बिकम सिंपलर. सो फॉर एवरी 1 रिजर्व सीट्स यू नीड 4 नेशनल असेंबली सीट्स. And then taking the number to simple 4 into 4, 16.
ये rule 94 के मुताबिक आप क्यों नहीं calculation करते जो prescribed formula in the rule 94?
वो मैं उसको लेकर आऊँगा. The
per centum share of each political party shall be worked out with reference to total number of general seats.
ये मैं
आपने कोई note बनाना था तो demonstration आपको
ये मैं भी आपको दिखा रहा हूँ अभी दिखाता हूँ.
जी party wise आप demonstrate करते
हैं. ये 13 seats हैं ये अरे ये मैं आपको मैं लाया इसलिए आपके सामने मैं 2002 की नेशनल असेंबली का ले आया आपके सामने व्हिच विल आल्सो ये इसका फॉर्मूला भी आपको दिखा देगा.
तो इलेक्शन एक्ट नहीं था 2017 का ना
सर रूपा था. नहीं इसके भी परसेंटेज शेयर जो वर्कआउट होना है वो अभी मैं आपको बताऊंगा. आप रूल 94 देखेंगे.
आपको तो जो शेयर कैलकुलेट करना है एज पर रूल 94 करना है.
जी जी 94
ने तो बिल्कुल उससे कोई डेविएट कर गया.
नहीं नहीं सर 94 को आप पढ़ेंगे सब रूल 2 ऑफ 95 के साथ जो कहता है कि इंडिपेंडेंट्स को आप एक्सक्लूड करेंगे
फॉर द पर्पसेस ऑफ. बना लेते ना कोई चार्ट जो आज करंट पोजीशन है इस वक्त जो
कि सर वो भी बनाया हुआ है. वो भी बनाया हुआ है
उससे ज्यादा सही पता
ये अभी ये
उसकी कितनी शेयर्स थी और कितना उनको इंडिपेंडेंट जो उनको ना मिलने से उनकी जो सीटें.
मैं वो भी बनाया हुआ है सर. वो भी बनाया हुआ
है. नहीं ये आप माय क्वेश्चन इज कि ये आप कह रहे हैं 2002 से यही फार्मूला इस्तेमाल हो रहा है. इज दैट व्हाट यू आर सेइंग.
आप जरा ये जरा थोड़ा सा जस्ट बेयर विद मी. मैं अभी आपको लेके जा रहा
हूं. व्हेदर दिस इज द कंसिस्टेंट फार्मूला दैट हैज बीन यूज्ड सिंस 2002 और इज दिस अ फार्मूला दैट हैज जस्ट बीन डिराइव्ड.
आप जरा अब ये आपके सामने आ गया जी पेपर.
जी आ गया
जी. अच्छा ये मैंने तो जरा सिंपलर फॉर्म में बनाया था. ये बिट कॉम्प्लिकेटेड बोथ अराइव एट द सेम रिजल्ट.
जो चार्ट आप ले रहे हैं उसमें इंडिपेंडेंट 14 थे.
यस
तो इंडिपेंडेंट जो है इतने सारे.
मैं वही आपको दिखाने लगा हूँ. वो दिखाने लगा हूँ.
वो फर्क बहुत आएगा आज के चार्ट के मुताबिक.
वो मैं आपको 2008 की बलूचिस्तान की एग्जाम्पल बताऊंगा. वहां पे भी मोर देन 20% इंडिपेंडेंट आ गए थे. बलूचिस्तान असेंबली की बात कर रहा हूँ कि 20% इंडिपेंडेंट आ गए थे. कंसिस्टेंट पोजिशन थी. रीजन आई से दिस इज माय लॉर्ड.
बट कैन आई जस्ट आस्क दैट यू आर आस्किंग अस टू लुक एट द चार्ट एंड द कैलकुलेशन and then give your explanation. Whereas the question is simply this, is this the formula that has been used up till now without any change or is this a new formula?
No, this is the, what
is
you
this
have
the formula
you?
That you have been using or the ECP has been using up till now? For how long have they been using this formula?
Consistently
since when?
Since 2002 when? से जब से ये रिजर्व सीट्स आई हैं यही फॉर्मूला.
जब लॉ बदला तो फिर ये फॉर्मूला नहीं बदला.
नहीं नहीं लॉ ने कोई चेंज नहीं किया उससे. लॉ जो है वो कंसिस्टेंट है. वो भी यही कर रहा है जो ये जो कैलकुलेशन कर रही है. एंड द रीजन फॉर दैट इज इफ यू टर्न टू अभी एक जरा रूल ही देख लेते हैं ना.
तो
रूल 2 देख लेना.
इस तरह आसान हो जाएगा रूल 95 में उसकी मैथ समझ.
जी जी रूल 94
आप एक्सटेंड कर रहे हैं. रूल 94
उसमें से मैथ्स जो बन रही है.
94 पे हम वापस आएंगे. बट पहले 95 के सब रूल 2 पर जाएंगे एंड देन वी कम बैक टू 94.
जी
बस दिस कंफ्यूजन इज एड्रेस्ड बाय सब रूल 2 ऑफ रूल 95. द सीट्स वन बाय इंडिपेंडेंट कैंडिडेट्स शैल बी एक्सक्लूडेड फ्रॉम द टोटल नंबर ऑफ जनरल सीट्स इन द नेशनल असेंबली और एज द केस मे बी द प्रोविंशियल असेंबली फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ डिटर्मिनेशन ऑफ शेयर ऑफ ईच पोलिटिकल पार्टी. अब आप अगर और मैं इसको अब जरा एलेबरेट करूं और इसलिए मैं आपको पहले वो कैलकुलेशन दिखाना चाह रहा था बिकॉज वहाँ पे रियल टाइम एग्जाम्पल
95 जरा पूरा पढ़ दें
जी पढ़ वो तो नेक्स्ट लेग है बट मैं उस पे
आता पहला वाला जी
The seats won by independent candidates shall be excluded from the total number of general seats in the National Assembly or, as the case may be, the Provincial Assembly for the purpose of determination of share of each political party, provided that if an independent candidate duly joins a political party under Subrule 6,